Let's now begin with revision of customs. In this first video, we will cover basics of customs. We will also be covering import procedure and export procedure. So let's begin. Customs comes from the union list. That means Article 246, read with 7th schedule of the Constitution, which provides for union, state and concurrent list. Customs is still applicable in the union list. Central government has the power to make the law, and central government has made Customs Act 1962. Section 12 of Customs Act 1962 is the charging section, which says custom duty will be applicable on any goods imported into India or any goods exported from India. But where do you get the rates of custom duty? The rates of custom duty are provided in Custom Tariff Act 1975. Now this Custom Tariff Act 1975 provides the rate of custom duty for import of goods as well as export of goods. See, normally import of goods custom duty will be applicable, export of goods custom duty will not be applicable. Reason being, in case of imports, the consumption is in India, while in case of exports, the consumption is outside India. Now, let's try to understand where does customs apply. Customs applies to the landmass, plus it also extends up to 200 nautical miles. There is a small term called as customs water, Indian custom water, which also extends up to 200 nautical miles. In this custom water, custom officers have special power to search, arrest or seize any goods conveyance or any person. Now, coming to the import procedure. Now, when we talk about how does import work, see, there are some key points. First, you should be very careful that import any vessel or aircraft or any other vehicle has to arrive at the designated port, airport or land custom station. Kahin aur nahi land ho sakta hai. It has to land at these places. Say suppose there is a stress of weather, in that case it can land at any other place, and whenever possible it has to be informed immediately to Central Board of Indirect Tax and Customs. Fine. So the first thing was arrival. Now there is a document called as import manifest. Who files this import manifest? This import manifest is filed by the person in charge. Who is the person in charge? Captain of the vessel or driver of the vehicle or pilot in case of aircraft. He will file an import manifest. This has to be filed before the vessel or aircraft comes into India. That means it is filed electronically. But when you talk about vehicle, vehicle can file the import manifest within 12 hours of its arrival at the land custom station. Now, whenever you talk about filing this import manifest electronically, it should contain details of all the goods which are there on that vessel or aircraft. Now, when we talk about giving all the details, the government also says for arms, ammunition, perishable goods or any hazardous goods, you have to give a separate declaration in the import manifest. And who is responsible to file this? Person in charge. Now, say suppose person in charge fails to submit this. In that case, there is a penalty of ₹50,000. And whom is this penalty applicable on? This penalty of 50,000 is applicable on the person in charge. Sir, if there is a mistake, is an amendment allowed in this import manifest? The obvious answer is yes. If there is a genuine mistake, you can inform the officer and get the amendment done. Clear? Okay. Now, they have also introduced one more document called as passenger and crew arrival manifest. What is this passenger and crew arrival manifest? whoever has come into India by that vessel, that also has to be reported. See, import manifest contains the details of goods. Passenger and crew arrival manifest contains the details of all the passengers and crew members who have arrived in India. Sir, if this is not filed, same penalty of 50,000 is applicable. And now what would happen? You have given the import manifest as a person in charge to the proper officer. What will proper officer give? Proper officer would give a entry inwards. Now, entry inwards signifies that now the vessel can come at the port. This entry inwards is not required for aircraft, not required for vehicles. It's only for a vessel. Until and unless entry inwards is given, unloading cannot begin. Okay. Once the entry inwards is given, unloading will begin. Hey, can you unload such goods which are not mentioned in the import manifest? The answer is no. Only those goods which are mentioned in the import manifest, only such goods can land into India. That's clearly provided in the law. Now, once the goods are unloaded, what would happen thereafter? Once goods are unloaded, thereafter, the custody of the goods will be given to the custodian. And who is the custodian? Port authorities are the custodians. If any goods are lost in the custody of the custodian, in that case, custodian is liable to pay custom duty. Clearly given in the law. Now, goods are with the custodian. Importer has to do something. What will he do? Importer will file bill of entry for home consumption. This is an integrated form which is filed electronically. Bill of entry for home consumption. What is the time limit for this? The time for filing this is next day after the arrival of vessel. Sir, what if I don't file it after the arrival next day? In such cases, can I file it afterwards? The answer is yes, you can file it afterwards with a small fee. Don't laugh. It's 5,000 per day for first 3 days, and from the fourth day it would be 10,000 per day. Yes, people, the fee is very high. 5,000 per day for first 3 days, from fourth day 10,000 per day. Sir, can it happen that this fee becomes more than the custom duty payable? This was a case for some time, but thereafter the law was amended saying that maximum will be custom duty payable. So it cannot exceed the custom duty payable given in the law. Now, while filing bill of entry, you also are required to make payment of custom duty. Now, when you are paying custom duty, at that point of time, the time limit given is on the date of filing bill of entry. The day you are presenting bill of entry, that day you will have to pay custom duty. Sir, if I delay payment of custom duty, interest at 15% per annum is applicable. So throughout customs, whenever you have to pay interest to government, it is always 15% per annum. In GST, it was 18% per annum. Clear? Okay. Now, thereafter, the officer will assess the bill of entry. That is, he will verify the bill of entry. It's also called as verification by proper officer. See, if he finds everything is correct, in that case, whatever custom duty you have paid is fine. But say, suppose he says, you have short paid custom duty. Now, if he says you have short paid custom duty, that amount has to be paid by you. And what is the time limit for paying that? Next day after you get that order from proper officer. So once proper officer gives a order for short payment of tax, in such cases you can pay that custom duty within next day. Sir, if I don't pay, again interest will be 15% per annum. So self-assessed tax has to be paid on the date of filing bill of entry for home consumption. and any short payment of tax has to be paid by end of a particular day, that is next day after you receive that order by proper officer. Okay, sir. Is there a deferred payment scheme available? Yes, for authorized economic operators, there is a deferred payment scheme. Any clearance which they do between 1st and 15th of the month, they can pay it by 16th of the month. Those clearances which they do between 16th and end of month, in that case, that can be paid on 1st of the next month. But for March, it has to be paid by 31st March. So that's a deferred payment scheme which is available for authorized economic operators. Now, payment of custom duty online is mandatory for any authorized economic operator, plus wherever the amount is more than 10,000, you will have to pay custom duty online. That is mandatory. Now, when we talk about a particular case of assessing the duty, say suppose you are not satisfied with what proper officer has said, proper officer says that you have to pay this amount. If you are not satisfied, you can go for provisional assessment, get the goods released. Otherwise, the other alternative would be going to an appeal because goods are with them, so you want the clearance to be done. If that is also taking time, then you can also transfer it to the warehouse by giving a bond. Now, this is the first part of the story. Say suppose you don't want to clear it for home consumption today. You don't have the resources. You cannot leave it at the port because first of all, government will charge 5,000 per day, and from the fourth day, government will charge 10,000 plus. Storing the goods at the port, expenditure is very high. So is there any other alternative? The answer is yes, you can store the goods in the warehouse. If you want to transfer it to the warehouse, you will file into bond bill of entry. And with this into bond bill of entry, you will have to give a bond assuring government that you will pay the taxes. And bond is thrice the duty amount, not twice, thrice the duty amount. So one part is for duty, one part is for penalty, one part is for interest and other charges. So government wants a bond thrice the duty amount. Once you give this, you can transfer the goods to the warehouse. Thereafter, when you want to clear the goods from the warehouse, you will be filing ex bond bill of entry. And by filing this ex bond bill of entry, you will also pay the taxes. Once you make the payment of taxes, thereafter goods will be cleared to your premise. Clear? Yes. Now, be very careful about one point. For how much time can you store the goods in the warehouse? These things are not there for your syllabus. Warehousing chapter has not been included for CA final. So you don't learn anything about warehouse except for this into bond, bond thrice the duty amount, filing of ex bond bill of entry and payment of custom duty. There is no other point which you learn with regard to warehouse. Okay. Now, say suppose you don't file the bill of entry and you are not clearing the goods. Can the custom authority sell the goods? Now, first of all, there is a power to the port authorities. Port authorities can sell the goods if the person has not cleared within 30 days. What they will do is, they will send you a notice, inform the proper officer and sell the goods to recover their rent. Custom officers also have the power to sell those goods, but it is not exercised until and unless you relinquish the goods. Relinquish matlab, aap bol doge ki mujhe ye goods nahi chahiye, you don't want these goods. If that is the case, then custom authorities can sell it. Otherwise, they will wait for clearance. But port authorities can sell the goods if you don't clear within 30 days. But before selling, they will send you a notice and inform the proper officer. In case of some perishable goods, hazardous goods, in that cases, 30 days limit will not apply. They might sell it even before the expiry of 30 days. This is regarding import procedure. Then you have two important points, which is transit and transshipment. Now, what is the meaning of transit and transshipment? Okay, let me tell you. Now, when you talk about transit, see, it is very well possible that a vessel is carrying goods for India and it is also carrying goods for Sri Lanka. So, the vessel first comes to India, comes to Mumbai port, unloads the goods, and then the vessel goes to Sri Lanka. Such goods are called as transit goods. The vehicle has not changed. Conveyance has not changed. Goods are still going to Sri Lanka in the same vessel. These are called as transit goods. Transit goods are allowed to be moved without payment of custom duty. It might also be a case where some goods belong to Chennai. These are also transit goods at Mumbai, because they will not be unloaded at Mumbai, it will be unloaded at Chennai. Clear? What is transshipment? Transshipment is where the vessel changes. Goods are transferred from one vessel to another, and then that another vessel goes to Sri Lanka or Chennai. In such cases, transshipment is also allowed without payment of custom duty. And thereafter, once it reaches Sri Lanka, we are not bothered. The goods which are bound to Chennai, it will be unloaded at Chennai and it will be assessed to tax in Chennai. So, be very careful about this. Transit goods and transshipped goods, both are allowed without payment of custom duty. In transshipment, there is a transshipment permit which has to be taken. In fact, Chennai to Bangalore is also a case of transshipment. What happens is, containers come to Chennai, they are not assessed at Chennai. From Chennai, it moves to Bangalore Inland Container Depot or Container Freight Station, and then it is assessed or cleared from Inland Container Depot in Bangalore. That is also a case of transshipment. So, transshipment is moving the goods to any other place where it would be assessed to tax. Clear? Yes. Now, how does export procedure work? See, when we talk about export procedure, the first thing which you should understand is, first the exporter will file a shipping bill. And simultaneously, the vessel will also take the permission for exiting. So, that permission which they take is called as entry outward. And once these two activities are done, thereafter the proper officer will check the shipping bill. Normally, see, custom duty is not applicable, so he will not calculate anything. But if there is export duty applicable, in such cases, he will assess that duty. Export duty is rarely there on any product. Thereafter, once export duty is assessed and he checks it is not prohibited, he will pass an order. Who will pass an order? The proper officer will pass an order. Once he passes the order, goods will be loaded in the conveyance. Once the goods are loaded in a conveyance, thereafter an export manifest will be submitted. What is this export manifest? Export manifest contains details of all the goods which are loaded in a conveyance. And thereafter, he will take a leaving permission from the proper officer. Once this leaving permission is taken, the vessel will go away. In this leaving permission, you'll have to give a declaration saying that any custom duty which was payable has been paid, that would be checked. Plus, say suppose some goods are wrongly put in this vessel and it is not practical to take it out now. In such cases, the vessel operator has to give a declaration. Person in charge has to give a declaration saying that next time when I come back, I will surely bring these goods. And don't forget, if you don't file export manifest, penalty of 50,000. And with this, there is obviously a passenger and crew departure manifest. Passenger and crew departure manifest. Again, the penalty remains same for both of these. Clear with this? Yes. So, this is how the export procedure works. Yes, go through this entire custom basics. We'll meet in the next video. Thank you.